What's up, Achievers? Lauren.
Jason.
We're here together. We're both mic'd up, which is really exciting.
Double trouble.
So you get to hear from both of us today. We are going to be doing another strength workout. This time it is with one dumbbell, and we're going to show some more advanced variations along with some more modified variations so that you can choose what works for you based on your current ability level or the weights that you have. There's a lot of different reasons why you might choose one of the more advanced variations or one of the more modified variations. Whichever one you choose, you're a good person either way. So we hope that you make sure that you're just doing what feels best and right for you. All right. So if you feel like you want to choose some of the more advanced versions, you're going to follow along with me. If you want some of the more modified versions, you're going to follow along with Jason.
Team Jason.
Don't feel like you have to stick with one or the other. You can bounce back and forth depending on which movement we're doing. All right. So Jason's going to lead us through a warm up and then we'll get started.
All right. So just make sure you have some space around you, but we're going to get down onto the floor. All right. So exercise number one, or warm up drill number one, we're going to get hands right below your shoulders, knees right below your hips. And then from there, I want you to get your knees out wide. And then from there, let's drop down to your forearms. I want you to get your chest up tall. Try to look straight ahead. You're going to rock all the way forward and rock all the way back. All right. You're going to sink yourself all the way forward and then push yourself all the way back. And just hang out there for a second before coming back forward, all right? Just a good way to loosen up the inner thighs, loosen up the hips a little bit. We are gonna be squatting, and this is a great prep drill before we do our actual squats. All right, we're gonna get a couple more here. And last one. Cool. So this is a continuation. We're going to get back to your all fours position. And then from there, get your right foot forward as if you're about to do a Spider-Man lunge. Now, we're going to just do a rock back and forth with your leg up in this position. So as you're coming forward, you should feel some hips from the hip flexors in the back leg and also some inner thigh in this front leg. When you drift backwards, you should feel some hamstrings. All right. So just keep drifting back and forth and rocking back and forth. If you want to get a little bit more inner thigh as you come forward, just push your knee off to the side a little bit more and you'll find that you can sink down a little bit lower. Later on when we do squats, we'll tell you to push your knees out, and that's the reason why, because it helps you to sink down a little bit lower. All right, let's switch sides. Rock back and forth, keeping that chest tall and proud as you go back and forth. We'll get about four more. And last one. All right, perfect. Now from there, you're gonna lay down onto your stomach, and I want you to get your hands right tucked in really close. You're gonna get into a cobra pose. So hips are down on the floor and you're arching your back up like this. Then you tuck your toes under, and I want you to cycle back into a downward dog. All right, you hold that position for a second or two, and then bring it back into a cobra pose. All right, so we're loosening up your entire spine here when we're doing the cobra, and then when we drift back to downward dog, you're getting calves, hamstrings, lower back, all stretching out. All right, and you get two more, so back to your cobra pose. Nice, easy breathing. Back into your downward dog. Feel free to keep your knees bent for this one if you want to get a little bit more range. And last one, cobra. And downward dog.
I like your little wiggle.
A little shimmy. All right, cool. We're going to stand on up. And from there, final one, we're going to get into a hinge position. It's called a bent over T-spine rotation. All right, so you're going to hinge back with a flat back. Palms are like this. And you're going to basically rotate one side all the way up and then bring it back down. Rotate the other side up and bring it back down. We'll get about four on each side here before we get going. Lauren's gonna lead you through the exercises and the explanations, and I'll go over the modifications the second round. All right, last one on each side. Just a good way to loosen up the upper back. All right, perfect.
Cool, so now we're warm, we're ready to go. So what we're gonna do is three different circuits. The first circuit is going to be three exercises, 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest, and we're gonna go through it four times. So it'll be our longest work interval and also our longest circuit. After that, we'll take a rest, then we're gonna get into another circuit, three exercises, 30 on, 15 off for three rounds, and then finally a little quicker finisher at the end. All right, but we'll just focus on one thing at a time so you don't have to memorize too many things. So the first circuit, three exercises, 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. We're gonna start with a squat to overhead press, and we have a couple different versions. So the more advanced version would be holding the outsides of your dumbbell here. You're gonna squat down, and you're gonna do a rotational press. So you press overhead, you pivot on that outside foot, pull it back down, squat, and switch directions. All right, Jason's gonna show the modification of a squat to a straight overhead press and pulling it back down. All right, so just not incorporating that rotation if that feels like too much coordination for you. After that, we're gonna go into an off knees single arm row or a quadruped single arm row. So for this one, I definitely do recommend having something to elevate your non-working hand on. So if you have yoga blocks would be an awesome option. If you have a book at home, that would be great. Or if you have another dumbbell you can elevate your hand on, that's just gonna get you a little bit more range of motion with this movement. All right, so we're gonna go into this quadruped position, but bring your knees slightly off the ground for the more advanced version, and we're gonna row. We'll do 20 seconds on one side, and then we'll do a quick switch, and 20 seconds on the other. All right, and then what Jason's gonna be doing is the same move, but with his knees staying on the ground, so there's less of an anti-rotation component, less of a core component to that, and you can focus a little more just on the row. All right, and then finally, we have a side plank. For the more advanced variation, we're gonna do a side plank with a knee tuck and a leg raise. So we'll be here, feet stacked or one in front of the other, whatever works for you. You'll send your hips up, hands on your hips or up to the ceiling, whichever works for you there. You're gonna go knee tuck, down, leg raise, and down. All right, tuck in, and then up. And then of course, modification would be a straight up side plank hold, or if you need to modify further, you can do a kneeling side plank hold. Sound good? All right, so a lot to remember. Don't worry, we're gonna be walking you through this and giving you cues and tips and things as we go through. For round one, I'm gonna be doing the talking. So if you're doing the more advanced version, kind of just cue into what I'm saying. If you're choosing the modification, just watch Jason, and then round two, he's gonna give you a couple more tips and pointers for his version. Sound good? All right, so let's get ready for our squat to overhead press. We're gonna go in 5 seconds, so get your weight set up. Holding the outsides, we got 2, 1, and go. So squatting and pivoting. We're pressing away from the leg that you're pivoting. All right, and we wanna think about really rotating your hips and getting those arms straight up overhead. Nice job. All right, now because this is a longer round, we're focusing on strength and we're focusing on technique and mindfulness, and not necessarily on how fast you go. All right, this one should be more mindful and a little bit more slowed down. We got 5 more seconds. 2, 1, and rest. Beautiful, we're gonna go into those rows. So come on down to the floor in your quadruped position. If you have something to elevate your hand on, even better. We're gonna start in 10 seconds. We're gonna do 20 seconds on one side. I'll tell you to switch, and 20 seconds on the other. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. So your knees are hovering just over the floor. And the big challenge here is making sure we're not rotating or letting your knees do any movement. We're trying to stay as square to the ground as you can, pulling that shoulder back as you roll your hand toward your hip. In 3, 2, 1, switch sides. Quick as you can, safely, and right into it. Very nice. Now, if you don't have something to elevate your hand on, no problem. You can do this on the floor. You're just gonna notice that it stops you a little short of fully extending your arm, but that's totally fine. We can focus on the top. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Beautiful. All right, move your equipment slightly out of the way. We're gonna go into our side plank. All right, yeah, we'll go this way first. Stack your feet or 1 foot in front of the other. We're gonna do 20 seconds on one side and then a quick transition over to the other side for the second 20 seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's go. So we're doing tucking that top knee in, planting it back down, and then heel straight up, or the side of your foot straight up toward the ceiling. Tuck it in and leg lift. That leg lift is super challenging. All of this is putting a lot more pressure on that bottom leg to stabilize. 2, 1, quickly switch over to the other side, a little rotation there, and go right into the other side. All right, I want you to think about pressing your right forearm hard into the floor to stabilize that bottom shoulder. Nice job. Keep it going, keep breathing. We got 2, 1, and rest. Beautiful job. All right, that's one round down. We're going round two, starting with our squat to press. Jason's gonna take over the coaching.
All right, so this is going to be for the modifications, all right? So we're gonna start off with squat overhead press. This one you don't have to rotate, but obviously if you are doing the more advanced variation, feel free to keep rotating along with Lauren, all right? And go. So squat down and press directly overhead. So not too many cues here, but the big thing is we're going for 40 seconds. Definitely go at your own pace. Don't feel like you have to get as many as you can in 40 seconds, especially if you have a heavier weight, but go according to your pace rather than just going with our flow, all right? So definitely go, meet yourself where you're at. All right, got 15 seconds. Perfect, and you're really using the legs to drive the weight up, right? So pushing into the floor and use a little bit of that momentum to push the weight up. One, and time, good. And rest, shake it out. We've got our quadruped single arm rows, and for this variation, I'll show you this way, profile view. Get going in about 10 seconds. All right, 5 seconds here. 3, 2, 1, and go. So for 20 seconds, we're rowing on this side. So you'll notice my knees are on the floor, but the same rules apply. I'm trying to stay as square as possible while rowing, all right? One other little helpful tip is to really push into the floor or that block or textbook that you have with your free hand. All right, and switch. And row. So technically the non-working arm is the arm that isn't rowing, but you're still really being active with that arm in order to have a total body effect. All right, and 3, 2, 1, and good. All right, we got our side plank coming up. And I'll show this bent knee this time. We get going in about 12 seconds. If you are going bent knee, just stack both knees on top of each other and tuck your feet back. All right, we're gonna get going in 3, 2, 1, and go. All right, so lift those hips up. And you're just thinking about a straight line from the top of your head all the way down to your knee. All right, so we're not piking at all. We're not rounding over, but we're getting as long as possible.
I feel like my foot is going right in your face. Sorry if I'm blocking Jason.
All right, 2, 1, and switch.
Still working on our spacing.
Getting slowly better. Good, again, staying as long as you can. You should feel those obliques working. And just like last round, we're really thinking about pushing down into the floor with that bottom arm. Keep on going. We got 3, 2, 1, and good. All right, we got 2 more rounds. From here on out, it's gonna be free for all. Lauren and I are gonna be talking over each other. We're gonna be interrupting each other. It's gonna be pure chaos, but we'll have some fun with it.
All right, oh, take a couple deep breaths. Get ready, we got 5 seconds for round 3. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Squat and press. You can feel free to stick with the variation that you chose from the beginning, or if you wanted to start out with the more modified version and then work toward the more advanced version, you have the freedom to change it up, all right? This is your workout. You do what works for you. We're halfway through. Nice job. Whichever one you're choosing, make sure that weight's going straight overhead. It can be tempting to press it out in front of you slightly. We want it to end up arms right next to your ears. In 3, 2, 1, and rest.
Awesome.
Beautiful. Whew. All right, bring it down to the floor. Get ready for that row.
All right, so remember with that down arm, really push into the floor regardless of which variation you're choosing, all right? So that down arm is gonna be really important.
3, 2, 1, let's go. Nice job. And if you're doing these off knees, again, important to try to go slowly through this. If you're rushing, you're probably rotating, moving those hips. Slow it down, it's actually gonna be harder. Let's switch sides. This first round is all about mindfulness, strength, and control throughout all of your movements.
Precision, grace, humanity.
All the cliches. 2, 1, and rest. I was being serious. You had to take it there. All right. Were my feet right in front of your face?
Yeah, but it was fine.
Okay. All right. 10 seconds to get started. I have my brand new strike movement shoes on.
There you go.
Shameless plug for a company that doesn't sponsor us. But anyway, and go for it.
So it helps to think about, imagine that you're leaning back against the wall right now. So you're trying to keep contact with your head, your upper back, your hips, your feet. Everything is back up against the wall, okay? So it helps to visualize that. We're gonna switch to sides in 3, 2, 1, and switch. Quick switch.
So fancy with that switch. If you're doing this advanced version, make sure that when you pull that knee in, you're not tempted to crunch your whole body forward. We're just moving at the hip flexor. And like Jason was saying, everything else stays like it's against that wall. All right, take a break. Okay, only one more round to go.
Final countdown.
Whew, we got this. It's a little shoulder heavy.
It is,
feeling my shoulders. All right, we can do this.
It feels good.
It feels really good. It's nice to do it with someone you love, you know? 2, 1. Let's go.
It's the day after, actually 2 days after Valentine's Day.
Oh yeah. We should have made this before. Oh, well. Nice job. We're
shoulders
at the halfway.
Halfway there.
If at any point your shoulders are not having it, you just keep that weight.
You just go take
at
a nap.
Your chest. All right, you can always just squat if you need to. Or take a nap. It's
Five
up
seconds.
To you.
3, 2, 1. Woo. All
right. Awesome work, awesome work. Back down to our rows.
10 seconds.
Take some nice deep breaths. Fully recover. And 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Good. Now make sure when you're doing these that you're not letting that shoulder, working shoulder round forward. We want to think about pulling the shoulder blade back, rowing that weight more toward your hip than toward your shoulder. Nice job. 3, 2, 1. Quickly switch sides and right into it. Nice job. Don't forget about that down arm pressing into the floor so that you're not sinking into that shoulder blade. We got 3, 2, 1, and rest. Whew. All right, team, one more. We got our side plank, and then we get a nice little rest, water break.
The shoulders are sneaking this one too, because you're really pushing into the ground, right?
Yeah, if you're doing them right, this whole thing is shoulder heavy.
All right, here we go, 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1, and go. Don't forget about your neck position here. Make sure you're not drooping down or forward. Pull that chin back. Nice work, nice work. 3, 2, 1, switch it over.
Get those hips up a little bit higher. They're gonna start to droop as you get tired. Keep pushing into the floor with that arm.
Come on, we're almost there. You got this. We got 5 seconds. 2, 1, done. Oh, high fives.
Oh.
High fives to you. High five your camera if you don't have a partner working with you. And let's get a quick sip of water. All right, I want you to take a moment to recover while I set my timer for the next round.
Circuit number 2. We've got 2 more circuits left. Circuit number 2 is going to be, actually, I'm stealing Lawrence Thunder here.
Oh, I don't mind.
It's going to be 30 seconds on, 15 seconds off, 3 rounds, and we got 3 exercises. Again, similar format. Lawrence is going to be showing the more advanced variations. I'll be showing the modified versions, but similar format as last time.
Yes.
Cool.
Here you go. So what we're going to start with is a reverse lunge. If you're going to choose the more advanced version, you're going to hold the outsides of your dumbbell again. You're going to lunge back. And when you do, you're going to rotate your upper body a little bit and let the dumbbell come outside of the front leg. And then we come back to the middle and it comes outside the front leg again. All right. As you get more comfortable with that, it kind of flows one into the other, so you're not even pausing at the top, you're kind of going one right into the next. The other version is a goblet reverse lunge, so the dumbbell is staying in place and the focus is just on that lunge. Awesome. Then we're gonna go into a bicep curl to front raise, so a little bit more of an aesthetics one here. We're just gonna bring that dumbbell up, down, out in front, and down. If you're using a heavy bell and that front raise is a little too much, do two or three bicep curls and then try to sneak in a front raise when you can. All right, and then finally, we're gonna do a tall plank dumbbell transfer for the advanced version or just a shoulder tap for the modified version. So for the advanced version, you're in a tall plank with your feet a little wider than shoulder width. You're gonna reach through, transfer the dumbbell over to the other side, place the hand back down, reach through, and switch it again. Your goal is not to let your hips rock side to side. Other version, same positioning, but you're doing a shoulder tap. So you're just not adding the weight, but you're still having that hand leave the floor for a little bit more of that anti-rotation challenge. All right, easy enough. 30 on, 15 off, so now we're moving a little quicker, and it's only three rounds. The hardest part is
piece
for sure behind us, all right? So we're gonna start with our lunges in 5 seconds. Get yourselves set. We're going in 3, 2, 1, let's go. So if you're rotating, remember the dumbbell goes to the outside of the front leg. All right, we're focusing on just a slight rotation at the shoulders, but kind of keeping your belly button still pointed forward. All right, so it's more your upper back is rotating while everything else stays square. 10 more seconds here. Thinking about 90 degree angles with your legs at the bottom. Knees stay behind your toes. 2, 1, and rest, nice and quick. Put that weight down, we have 15 seconds. We're gonna go into our curl to front raise, either alternating or a few curls into a raise. Here we go, in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Curl and raise, awesome. Now while we're doing this, we're not forgetting about our mindfulness, we're still thinking about our posture. I want you to think about your rib cage sitting directly over your pelvis, all right? So if you're watching from the side, I'm not letting my back arch or letting my rib cage flare, everything is staying nice and connected. And we're just focusing on those biceps and those shoulders. We got 3, 2, 1,
Ooh.
Take a rest. Nice job. I decided to kill her shoulders today. I don't know what I was thinking. All right, we're coming on down to that tall plank variation of choice. So either the weight transfer or the shoulder tap if you're following Jason. 2, 1, let's go. So the main consideration here is keeping your hips square to the ground. There should be no movement through your torso as you lift that hand off. That's the challenge here. All right, keep those hips stable, belly button pointed toward the floor. Think about tilting your hips under slightly, squeezing your glutes. Nice job, 5 more seconds, we got this. 2, 1, and rest. Beautiful job. See, this one flies by.
Yeah.
All right, we're going into round two. Jason's gonna lead the way this time. We're back to our lunges.
Whew, all right. 5 seconds, we'll get going. 3, 2, 1, and go. Alternating lunge as you're staying nice and tall. Sneaky part of this is that we're taxing the shoulders here because we're grabbing in that goblet position, but doing our best here to stay upright. And like what Lauren mentioned before, we're trying to keep 90 degree angles at the bottom with both shin angles, all right? As you're lunging back and forth. All right, we got 8 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, whew. Good, rest 15 seconds. We've got our curl to front raise coming up. One other kind of sneaky way to modify the front raise is coming up is just to have your arms bent a little bit more, okay? So you don't have to keep them perfectly straight. 1, and go. So curl and front raise, all right? Curl and front raise. Towards the end of last set, I started doing a few more curls for every front raise because it just helped to, you know, meet myself where I was at because my shoulders were dying and my biceps were fairly rested.
Your biceps?
My biceps. You can't see them because they're spying on you right now. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. All right, cool. Rest 15 seconds. We've got our tall plank shoulder taps. Same concept as the the rows from last circuit, really push into the floor with that bottom arm that's not tapping. 2, 1, and go. So pushing into the floor with that bottom hand each time, and that helps to keep you really square as you're going back and forth here. So your hips are square to the ground. Imagine a laser shooting out of your belly button, and you're trying to keep it square right in front of you the whole time. So it's not, you know, spraying everyone in sight. 2, 1, and good.
It was a really good analogy until the laser started spraying.
Bet you never heard that phrase before.
Okay, let's get into our last round. We're going back to our lunges. Final round, third and final. Let's go. In 3, 2, 1, here we go. Now, if you're doing these rotational lunges, another thing to consider is that when you bring that weight to the outside, it does tend to make you want to let your knee cave in, but we want to resist that, all right? So try to think about keeping your knee pointed over your midfoot.
Halfway there.
10 more seconds, nice job. Good work, everybody. 3, 2, 1, ooh. Excellent job. Rest those arms for a second so we can get into those bicep curls, front raises, or whatever combination you need to do. In 2, 1, let's go. Good. A lot of times, bodybuilding moves are said to be less functional, but I do find bicep curls and front raises very functional as a parent, because you're definitely carrying, lifting, placing in the crib, all those things that actually require you to have these weights out in front of you or in close to your body. So I think this is super functional. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Awesome. Back down to our planks. We're through the circuit. We got this.
It's flying by.
It's flying.
Flies by when you're having fun.
That's a cliche.
2, 1, and go.
Nice work here. Keep thinking about pressing into the floor with your hands. Your hands should be active, spreading those fingers so you can grip the floor. Ten more seconds. We're out of words. We're just making it through
no
this
words.
Last
just
round.
Just keep going.
Come on. 3, 2, 1, and done.
Ooh.
Awesome. High fives. Oh. High fives to you. Great job. All right. Let's get a sip of water. And we're gonna get ready for our finisher. Best part, because it's the quickest. Worst part, because it's the moves the fastest. So there's pros and cons.
Circuit number 3, 3 of 3. You wrote circuit number 30, actually.
I did.
20 seconds on, 10 seconds off, 3 rounds, 3 exercises. Lauren, drop that beat.
Okay, so if you're doing the more advanced version, the first one is gonna be a single arm squat clean. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna bring that dumbbell between your legs, swing it back, bring it up to your shoulder, and go right into a squat. So it's back, up, and squat. All right, I'll show you from the side. You swing it back, bring it up to the shoulder, and squat down kind of simultaneously. All right, if you're not into that combo move, follow Jason. He's gonna be doing an offset squat, just holding the weight there the whole time. We're gonna do the right side for exercise number 1, left side for exercise number 2, then we're gonna drop the weight down, come to a push-up position, and we're gonna do some mountain climbers. For this one, you have the options of either running those knees in and out, or slowing it down and walking the knees in and out. Either way, we're really making sure that we're not doing this. We're plopping our feet. All right, we're thinking about hovering your foot just above the floor as you go through these. All right, it's gonna move really quick. 10 seconds is like nothing. It's basically the transition time from one exercise to the next, but it's only 9 total rounds of 20 seconds, so it's really not so bad.
Lauren designed this workout. It's really sneaky. There's a lot of shoulders when there's not too much direct shoulder involved.
I know. It snuck up on me too. It's not like I did it intentionally. All right. We're gonna start with that right side squat clean or offset squat in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Nice. So we're thinking about using our hips as we bring that weight up to help us get it from between our legs to our shoulder and then dropping down underneath it to catch it in the squat. 3, 2, 1, take a break. I'm just gonna hold on to my dumbbell because it's really quick. We're just gonna switch sides and basically get right into it. Other side in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Squat clean on the other side. You may feel one side's a little less coordinated than the other. I'm a total righty, so my left side takes a second to get used to. That's all right. Nice job.
Oh boy. 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1. Oh. Drop it down for mountain climbers. Here we go. Only 5 seconds left. Come on. In 3, 2, 1. Let's go. All right, here again, active through those hands, pressing into the floor so you feel your shoulders working again. Shoulders should be stacked right over your wrists. If you're too far forward, your wrists are gonna feel it. All right, come on. 5 more seconds, you got this. 3, 2, 1, awesome.
Ooh.
2 more of those, come on.
2 more rounds.
We got this.
We got it. Lauren's got it, I'm gonna go.
Come on, 3, 2, 1, let's go.
All right, offset squats here. So you can rest one end of that dumbbell kind of on your shoulder as you're going through this, almost as if you were doing barbell front squats. All right, 7 seconds. And 3, 2, 1. And Lauren's gonna hold on to it, but I'm gonna completely let it go.
I feel like it's more work. I'm trying to save myself work.
All right, 3, 2, 1. And go. Also helps to have your free hand come out in front to counterbalance a little bit as you come down. All right, 10 seconds.
Oh, those quads. Woo.
Whew.
Come on.
5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right. Mountain climbers. Again, slow these down if you need to. Speed them up if you'd like. 2, 1. And go. I'm gonna go slower here. Lauren, show off, going super fast.
I'm not showing off, I'm just doing the advanced, doing what I was told, you
know?
That's
true, that's true.
Staying in my lane.
10 more seconds. Core, shoulders, keep it going. 3, 2, 1, awesome work.
All right.
All right, rest 10 seconds, last round.
Oh man, 3, 2,
oh no.
1, it's here, let's go. Come on, I always think that rest is gonna be longer than it is.
Helps to push those knees off to the sides as you're coming down. Whew. Three seconds. 3, 2, 1. Oh boy.
Oh my gosh.
Last two exercises, come on.
Your heart rate should be up at this point. If it's not, go faster. 2, 1.
Oh my God.
Let's go.
Felt like 3 seconds.
I know, you wasted all that energy putting it down on the floor and then picking it back up.
We're gonna talk about this later.
We should wear a heart rate monitor and see which one works harder. Come on, 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1. Ooh.
Last movement. Face each other.
Oh, duel.
We can do this.
Battle Royale.
A mountain climber off. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Come on. All the way through. This is our last hard effort.
Come on.
All the way to the end. Let's go. We got this.
10 seconds.
Drive the floor away. 5 seconds. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Oh, great job. If you can lift your arms. High five your camera. Awesome work. Oh man, that was hard.
All right, that was tough.
I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you had a lot of fun. We're gonna do a quick little cool down to start to down-regulate our system a little bit and get you ready to move on with the rest of your day. All right, let's start with a little hip flexor stretch. So we're just gonna swing your left leg out in front of you. All right, I'll show you from the side. Go ahead and tuck your back toes, or if it's more comfortable, untuck them. Whatever feels better on your knee. Think about tilting your hips under. So instead of arching your back, tuck, and then drive forward. Now we're just gonna hang out here and start to breathe. Some nice deep breaths. Ooh. Try to fill your belly and your ribs and your lungs with air. And then get that full exhale. Awesome. Go ahead and switch sides. Again, set yourself with your hips tilted under, then drive that back forward just slightly, but don't go into extension through your back. And just hang here and breathe.
Oh, I'm sweating profusely.
It was a cold, it's a cold day in Boston too, so to get sweaty in here is a testament.
That's good.
All right, let's stretch out your wrists a little bit because we did do some planking moves. So I want you to go ahead and get the backs of your hands down toward the floor with your fingers pointed back toward your knees. And we're just gonna hang out here and try to relax. If you need more of a stretch, bring your hands further out in front of you. If you need less, keep them in a little bit closer. Whatever feels like an appropriate amount. Just going into a little discomfort, but definitely not into any pain. This feels nice when we tend to be in extension all day, typing, planking.
Shooting lasers.
Shooting lasers. All right, go ahead and flip so that your wrists are pointed away from you, fingers still pointed back toward you. And now we're just getting the other side, stretching out the forearm, front of your forearm, or would you call that the front of your forearm?
I don't know. I think the back.
I know. Once I said it, I think it's the back. All right. Awesome. And let's do one more stretch for the hips. I want you to get into a 90-90 position. So that front leg is at 90 degrees with the knees out, back leg at 90 degrees with the knee in, and then just reach forward over that front leg slightly. You should feel a good stretch through the hip, through the glute. All right. And go as far as you need. If you're a little more bendy, you can drop down to your elbows. If you're a little tighter, stay up on your hands, whatever feels good. A couple breaths here. Beautiful. And go ahead and switch it over to the other side. Right leg is out, left knee is in. Leaning forward over that front leg. Should finally feel like your heart rate is coming back down to normal. Breathing's back down to normal. Awesome. All right. Ooh. That was fun. We had fun. Hopefully you had fun. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to leave you hanging. I didn't see you. I thought you were like getting ready to say something and I was like, go ahead, say it. What do you have to say?
Great job. Well done. Hopefully your shoulders are fried. Hopefully your legs are feeling it. Awesome work.
Yeah. Until next time.
Sweat out.
Happiness in. Oh.